Welcome. My name is Werner Vogels. I'm the Chief Technology Officer of Amazon.com. Right now, many scientists and researchers and professionals in the high-performance computing world are at Supercomputing 2010 in New Orleans. Since I can't be there in person, I wanted to tell you a bit about the latest developments in HPC on Amazon Web Services. The cloud is truly revolutionizing all businesses and industries, including HPC. During my academic career, I spent many years working on HPC technologies such as user-level networking, large-scale high-performance interconnects, HPC software stacks, etc. In those days, my main goal was to take the advances in building highly dedicated cluster environments and turn them into commodity technologies for the enterprise. Not just for HPC, but for mission-critical enterprise systems such as OLTP as well. Today, with the accessibility of cloud services from Amazon Web Services, we are making high-performance computing available as on-demand commodity for anyone to use. It is no longer a technology for the elite few with large budgets. After we launched Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, EC2, in 2006, our customers immediately started using it for high-performance computing because of its cost-effective on-demand compute access. Early users included Wall Street firms and hedge funds, academic researchers, pharmaceutical companies, digital media producers, and others. To respond to this growing customer segment and their specific needs, we launched cluster compute instances, which are specifically engineered to provide high-performance compute and networking. Continuing our tradition of listening closely to our customers, I'm excited to share with you a new HPC offering we released recently, the cluster GPU instance. This new instance type extends our cluster family by adding NVIDIA Tesla cards to cluster compute instances. We believe this will significantly lower the bar for customers who are interested in developing GPU applications. At Amazon Web Services, we are continually excited about the developments coming out of the HPC space, many coming from AWS customers such as NASA Jet Propulsion Labs, Eli Lilly, Harvard Medical School, and Berkeley Red Lab. We are equally excited about enabling these developments through new services and features. Stay tuned, though. It is still early in this technology revolution. And now, let me hand it over to Deepak Singh for an in-depth look at HPC on Amazon Web Services.
Hi, my name is Deepak Singh. I'm a Senior Business Development Manager for Amazon EC2 and a Cloud Computing Strategist at Amazon Web Services. I work with our largest customers in the areas of scientific computing, research computing, and large-scale business analytics. You just heard Dr. Werner Vogels, our CTO, talk to you about HPC and Amazon Web Services. I wanted to spend the next few minutes talking to you about our HPC offerings and telling you about our partners at Supercomputing 10. For many years, AWS customers have been using Amazon EC2 to solve a variety of computationally challenging problems. These have typically been embarrassingly parallel in nature, batch processing workflows, or data-intensive workloads using the Hadoop MapReduce framework, often using Amazon's Elastic MapReduce. However, many of our customers also expressed their interest to run tightly coupled I/O-intensive workloads on Amazon EC2. Given the distributed nature of the architecture, this was often challenging. Earlier this year, we launched the Cluster Compute instance. The Cluster Compute instance combines the elasticity, scalability, and on-demand nature of EC2 with a high-performance network that allows customers to solve challenging I/O-intensive workloads. What is the Cluster Compute instance? The Cluster Compute instance, or CC1, has two Xeon X5570 processors, which gives you a total of 8 cores. You have hyper-threading, so you have access to 16 compute threads, 23 gigs of 1333 gigahertz DDR3 memory, almost 2 terabytes of local disk space, and all of this on a 10 gig Ethernet fabric. We also introduced the concept of a placement group. All instances launched within a single placement group have full bisection bandwidth between all nodes in that group, essentially giving you a cluster. You can connect multiple placement groups, to form very large clusters, such as the 880 node cluster we used earlier this year for an HPL run, which gave us 41.82 teraflops of performance. For the last few years, GPUs have taken the HPC world by storm. At Supercomputing 10, you will hear a lot about GPUs and how they are the future of HPC. Many of our customers have expressed an interest in running GPUs in the cloud, often due to the challenges of running GPUs in your own facility. They are blocked by either by cost, by power requirements, or just the uncertainty of running large-scale clusters of GPUs when they're not sure if their applications are well-suited to the GPU architecture. I'm pleased to talk to you about our most recent offering. The cluster GPU instance was launched last week and adds to the cluster compute instance that I talked about earlier. In fact, it is exactly the same instance on the same network fabric, except that on each instance, you now have access to two NVIDIA Tesla M2050 GPUs. Researchers doing molecular dynamics, rendering, CFD, and a variety of other computational and technical tasks can take advantage of the cluster GPU instance and get performance several times faster than they might get on CPUs. You can learn more about the cluster GPU family by visiting NVIDIA and asking them a little bit more about the Tesla card, as well as how you can provision GPUs at Amazon Web Services. You might actually even get to see a demo. We have been working with a large number of partners who have enabled our customers to get onboarded onto the cloud much faster. All of you have heard of MATLAB. MathWorks has been a longtime partner of Amazon Web Services and has been supporting cluster compute instances from the day they were available. You can visit the MATLAB booth at SC10 and get a demo on how you can use Amazon Web Services and Amazon EC2, including the cluster compute family. You can also visit Cycle Computing, ClusterCorp, and Platform Computing to learn how you can provision clusters on Amazon Web Services using the cluster compute instance. We look forward to your feedback on the kinds of workloads that you might want to run on the cluster family and other HPC needs that you might have. We encourage you to visit aws.amazon.com/sc10, where you will find this video and learn more about our partners and other activities at Supercomputing. In fact, one activity I would welcome all of you to visit is a talk at the Intel Theater on the 16th of November at 1:30 p.m. Central Time. The cluster compute instance is built on the Intel platform. In that talk, you'll learn a little bit more about the architecture of the cluster compute instance. Our partners and customers like NASA JPL, who use the cluster compute family to solve complex image processing tasks. You can also hear a live webcast at 11 a.m. Central Time on the 16th, where I will be talking to you in a lot more detail about the cluster compute family and HPC on Amazon Web Services. We hope that you are able to use these instances. Give us feedback on what else you would like to use. Thank you very much.